So there are five stages, by the way, of the ruh. Very quickly go over them. Number one, the first stage, from the creation until before the fetus. We have no information about nothing from the Quran and Sunnah. Where is it? Who is protecting it? How is it living? Zero information. Nothing. The second stage, when the ruh is blown into the fetus and it remains in the body, and this is essentially what we are right now, and we can call this the wakeful state, the state of the child or the young man or the old man when they are awake. And this is the body and the soul are together and combined in one, and the both of them are conscious. This is the wakeful state, and this is what I hope all of us are in right now, inshallah. I hope none of us are in the third, which is the sleeping state, right? Anybody in the sleeping state, you can raise their hand, and that's a problem. The third is the sleeping state. And the sleeping state, the ruh leaves the body, but not permanently. The ruh leaves the body, but not permanently. And there is some connection that the ruh has with the body. What that connection is, we really don't know. But there is some connection. Ibn al-Qayyim mentions in his kitab al-Ruh, and others mention this as well, that there seems to be some type of thread connection, like a minuscule, invisible thread between the body and the ruh. That the ruh and the body are still somehow... Now this isn't an actual thread, you cannot cut it with... It's a metaphysical thread, it's a thread that is from the ruh world, not from the body world. And the ruh and the body are connected, and that's why when something happens to the body, the ruh rushes back and you just wake up. Whoa, what happened? Like it comes back immediately. You wake up with the jolt, right? So the ruh is coming back immediately. So the issue of the ruh separating from the body during sleep is something that is explicit in the Quran and in the Sunnah. This is something very clear, and it is a part of our theology to believe. What is sleep? Sleep is the temporary separation of the ruh from the body. And of course, there is the famous verse in the Quran that mentions this. Which verse is this? O Hufaz, Ya Hafadha. Where are the, which verse am I talking about? Which one? Where is it? Yes, very good. Surah Az-Zumar, very good. Allah says in the Quran, Allahu yatawaffa al-anfusa hina mawtiha wallati lam tamut fi manamiha. Allah takes two souls. Allah takes two souls, two categories. Number one, when the souls die. Allahu yatawaffa al-anfus, right, when they die. Number two, wallati lam tamut fi manamiha, and those that are not dead but they're asleep. So Allah is explicitly saying, I take the souls of those who are sleeping. So sleeping, Allah takes the soul away. But it is a temporary taking away. The barzakh doesn't begin there. The barzakh begins when the connection breaks between the body and the soul. And that's why our Prophet ﷺ also said, for example, he said, An-nawmu akhu al-maut. This is an authentic hadith. Three words. An-nawmu akhu al-maut. Sleeping is the brother of death. Sleeping and death are twins. Sleeping and death are very similar. And that is why it's very common for people to pass away in sleep. Because Allah says, فَيُمْسِكُ الَّذِي قَضَى عَلَيْهَا الْمَوْتِ. Those whom Allah has decreed will die in their sleep, Allah says, He keeps the soul. وَيُرْسِلُ الْأُخْرَى. And the others, He sends them back until their time will come. This is all in the Quran. And that's why it's very common. One of the most common ways of dying is a peaceful death, when you go to sleep and you just pass away, you don't wake up. This is mentioned in the Quran. So this person, his soul went to sleep, then the soul is taken away, and then death occurs. So this is the third state, right? So memorize this. This is something that we should all know. Number one, pre-birth. Number two, and this begins in the wombs of our mother, and that is the relationship we have right now. Because by the way, modern science has shown, even the fetus is awake and asleep. Even in the womb of your mother, there are states when you're awake and there are states when you're asleep. Subhanallah, this is hadha khalqullah. That even that pre-born child, right? The child inside the womb of the mother is already awake and asleep. And then when the child comes out and we are now that stage, it's the same in terms of the relationship between the body and the soul. So the second we said is the wakeful state. The third is the sleep state. And because sleeping is the brother of death, there shall be no sleep in Jannah or in Jahannam. There is no need to sleep because there is no death. You will perpetually be awake without caffeine. Can you believe? Although you can drink caffeine if you want, inshaAllah ta'ala, because some of us, whatever you want in Jannah, you will get. And anything halal, and caffeine is halal. So, where am I going, subhanAllah? How did that tangent come along? What was I saying? My mind is completely blank. So there is no sleep in Jannah. Why is there no sleep in Jannah? Because sleep is what? The taking of the body out of the soul, and that's not going to happen in Jannah. So there is no sleep in Jannah. You're never going to get tired in Jannah. That's the third state. The fourth state, and that is the Barzakh. And the Barzakh is this time frame when the ruh and the jasad break the connection, when the ruh and the jasad break the connection, and that ruh then goes into this zone called the Barzakh, and then the fifth state comes, and the fifth state is when the final trumpet is blown. Not the first trumpet, the final one. But the point is, the Barzakh lasts until the last trumpet, not until the first trumpet. When the first trumpet is blown, the first trumpet is for this dunya, not for the people of the Barzakh. The people of the Barzakh have nothing to do with that first trumpet. The second, and the Barzakh lasts until the second of the two trumpets. Then the fifth stage begins, and that is the final stage. And what stage is that? The permanent reuniting of the ruh with the jasad in the next world. So the jasad is not the jasad of this dunya, flesh and bones. It's a different type of jasad. يَوْمَ تُبَدَّرُ الْأَرْضُ غَيْرَ الْأَرْضِ وَالسَّمَاوَاتِ It's a different creation of Allah. Not this creation. Not this world that we live in. It is a different world. And when that reuniting occurs, that is going to be the permanent reuniting and the most perfect reuniting that overshadows all previous four stages. And that is why there is no maut, there is no sleeping, there is no tiredness, there is no negative issues once that happens and the ruh and the jasad are fully reconnected.